on, dear students. Yesterday, our class, let us recapitulate few questions. Yesterday, I explained you about the deltas, isn't it? Yesterday, I explained you about the deltas. So, I would like to ask few questions yesterday. Okay, name the two rivers which flows from Western Ghats. Yesterday, I told two rivers which starts from the Western Ghats. Which two rivers are those? Yes, good. Godavari and Krishna. Second question, where does Godavari river enters into Telangana? Yesterday I said it starts from Maharashtra from Western Ghats, but in Telangana, in which place it enters, in which district it enters? Yes, very good. It's Nirmal district near Basara. I said Basara Saraswati Devi temple is there. Third question, how deltas are formed? When river water flows, it brings lot of, it carries lot of sand and silt and before joining into the sea. So this Godavari and Krishna, if we take, it joins into Bay of Bengal. Okay, when it nears to the sea, these rivers split into small streams and it flows with a small channels. Channels means like a line, very small little water flows. So in this it fills lot of sand and silt. So in this way the deltas are formed. So even these answers I'll post at the end of this lesson. Now let us go for the third lesson, part 2, that is Penamakuru. Already I said that in the coming lessons we will go to the landforms, like how the people are living in the delta region, how people are living in plateaus, how the people are living in mountainous region. So now let us, through this lesson, let us visit a village, Penamakuru, okay, which is on the Krishna Delta. Penamakuru, a village on the Krishna Delta. Okay, students. So, already in the previous lesson, we discussed about the deltas. So, Penamakuru is a village on the Krishna Delta. And you know one interesting thing, students. Before writing these lessons, some of our professors, they visited personally to the Penamakuru village. Okay, students. Okay, personally, they have visited Penamakuru village. Let us see where is its location, how they traveled. So here in the lesson they used the word we means here our professors. So they wanted to, we wanted to see how people living in a delta village given in the textbook. We means here who? The professors. The professors wanted to see how the people live in the delta region. So they started their journey from Vijayawada, and from where they started their journey from Vijayawada. Okay, students. Then they reached from Vijayawada, Uyuru town. Which town they reached? Uyuru town. Okay. So, when they reached, they observed that their terrain. Terrain means the landform is completely plains. No hills. It's a completely plains. Okay. And they crossed, when they visited Uyuru town, when they were starting, they started on foot, they crossed a number of canals. They crossed a number of canals. Do you know, students, what are canals? See, actually canals, have you seen our drainage, moris or not? Nowadays it's not there. But actually how will be the canal? I'll really explain. See, with the stones, two sides, like small wall they will build. And it will be very broad. So, near this Vijayawada, which river is flowing? Krishna river is flowing. So, when river is flowing, some of that water, they will dig here. They will build two sides with stones and cement, like wall they will build. Here, the ground will be slope, downward. So, some of the river water flows through this canal. Okay, students. And through this canal will be built for many kilometers up to... If they want the canal in the Penamakuru village. So, from nearby, the Krishna river is flowing from there to up to where they want, up to there they will build the canal. So, this water flows into the village. And that water, mostly they will use for their agriculture fields. Okay, students. So, like that, when our professors, they were walking, they have observed number of canals. And they observed many channels. Channels means here the agriculture fields, if agriculture crop is like this. Okay. So here plants will be there. Here plants will be there in between small channels. Here water. they'll send water. These are called the channels. So like that, they have seen some channels with the green trees. Now let us see Bandar Canal. How our professors reached Panamakuru village? Let us see. Okay. Again, at the end of the lesson, I'll ask you few questions. So listen very carefully. Of course, you'll not tell answer, but you should know. Okay. Fine. Now Bandar Canal. Bandar Canal. Okay. So our professors, after traveling about 3 kilometers, already I said that they reached Uyuru town. So from Uyuru town, how many kilometers they traveled? They traveled 3 kilometers. They traveled 3 kilometers. Then they crossed Bandar Canal and they reached. They crossed Bandar Canal. First they went to Vijayawada. From there Uyuru town they went. From Uyuru town they traveled 3 kilometers. So after crossing Bandar Canal, they reached Panamakuru village. Once again, I repeat, students, our professors, they reached Vijayawada. From there to they went to Uyuru. From Uyuru, they traveled 3 kilometers. When they traveling, they crossed Bandar Canal. It is also canal now. Just now I said many canals they have crossed. So Bandar Canal is also one of the canal which they crossed. After crossing Bandar Canal, Panamakuru village is there. So they reached Panamakuru village. So to Bandar Canal, from where the water is coming here, from Prakasham barrage. You know, barrage means what? It's nothing but a dam. Prakasham barrage. So this Bandar Canal, through the Bandar Canal, which water is coming? Krishna water is flowing. From where it's they are sending? They are sending from the Prakasham barrage. Okay. So it flows from the west of the village. See, if example, even I'll post pick from the textbook. So, Panamakuru village is there. Okay. So, from where it's flowing, let us see. It flows from the west of the village towards southeast. So, this is Panamakuru village, you think. This is east. This is east. From west, this is north, this is south. So, this water from west side, it flows like this through this village. Southwest direction, this water flows, canal water. Okay. Now, so where is Panamakuru village exactly situated? It's situated between the Krishna river, which flows to the west of the village, a few kilometers away from the village, and the Bandar Canal. That means this village is in between the Prakasham barrage and Bandar Canal. The Panamakuru village is there. And where, what is this village actually? The landform on the delta. It is on the delta. And you know, students, this Prakasham barrage is built at Vijayawada on Krishna river. And you know, this Prakasham barrage, this dam was built by Britishers in 1853. When this dam was built, it was built in 1853 by our British rulers, built by Arthur Cotton. Okay, after independence, in the name of Sitanguturi Prakasham garu, on his name, this dam named as Prakasham barrage. Understood, students? Where this Prakasham barrage built? At Vijayawada on river Krishna. And it was built by Britishers in 1853. So after that, they named on the name of Minister Sitanguturi Prakasham Pantulu. Okay, that's why it named as a Prakasham barrage. Even now also it is the name is the same, Prakasham barrage. Okay, students? So next, let us go and see in the Panamakuru village. Shall I ask you a few questions? Are you ready? Or some more shall I discuss? First, let us discuss about some of the soils of this Panamakuru. Okay, Panamakuru. In Panamakuru, let us see what type of soils are available. So, where is Panamakuru village situated? It is situated between the Prakasham barrage and Bandar Canal. Okay, students. Once again, shall I repeat? Or no need. Where it is situated? It is located between the Krishna river and Bandar Canal. In between these two, this village is situated. Now let us see what type of soils. Now we are talking about the delta region. This is the delta region. Okay, already yesterday we discussed the floods will bring lot of humus, topmost layer of the soil, which makes the delta region very fertile. Fertile meaning is good soil. Fertile means what? Good soil, which is good for growing crops. Okay, students. Now let us see what type of soils are available in Penamakuru village. Okay, very carefully listen. See here, in Penamakuru, mostly alluvial black soil is there. Which soil? Alluvial black soil. What type of soil? The most fertile soil. The most fertile soil, that is alluvial black soils. And the soils, so these soils are deposited by the river. So the soil is deposited by river. Once again I repeat, students, in Penamakuru village the most fertile soil, alluvial black soil, is deposited, and it is deposited by the river. And let us see the features of alluvial soil. Okay, these alluvial black soils are heavy. Can you see what I am writing on the board? It's heavy and have water holding capacity. And have water holding capacity. Now I will explain. Don't worry. Don't be confused. What is this teacher is saying? Water holding capacity and all. Okay, students. Now you see, here alluvial black soil, which is very very fertile. And how it is deposited by the rivers. And the soil is very fertile. Fertile means what I said? Good soil. Okay. And the soil is heavy in weight. And this will hold water for a long time. Means what, you know, if water is filled or with rain water is filled in this soil, most time this soil will be wet. The soil will be wet. That's why I use it the word have water holding capacity. Okay, it will be wet for a long time. So, and even the soil is rich in nutrients. That's why it is fertile soil. The soil is rich in nutrients. You know, students, one answer I am explaining. You should listen very, very carefully now. Alluvial soils are heavy and have water holding capacity. This is first point. Second, they are rich in nutrients. So, these nutrients helps the crops to grow. Okay. Then, and even this is the first kind of soil which we find in Penamakuru. One more type of soil we will find in Penamakuru village. We can find fine and clay black soil. You know, this alluvial soil are also called Ondru Bhumi. In Telugu also he gave in the textbook to understand. Alluvial black soil is also called Ondru Bhumi. What it is called? Ondru Bhumi. Okay, students. Shall I repeat once again? In Penamakuru village, alluvial black soil is available, and this soil is also called Ondru Bhumi, and it is very fertile soil. Okay, it is deposited by the river, and the soil is heavy and have water holding capacity. For long time it will hold water. Wetness will be there more for long time. Then it is rich in nutrients. Now second type of soil available in this village is what? Chalaira. I think so you have understood. Second type of soil let us discuss. Okay, students. Second type of soil which we are going to discuss is clay soil. Clay soil, do you know? Clay. Already nowadays the artificial clay, color clays are available. So this is which we are talking clay. This is clay black soil, which black in color, and it is a natural soil. Okay, students. So this black clay, this is the second type of soil available in Penamakuru village. One is, first one I said, alluvial black soil or Ondru Bhumi. Second soil is clay black soils. What it is? Clay black soils. And this is also called in Telugu Nallaregadi Bhumi. What it is called? It is called Nallaregadi Bhumi. I am not telling, it's given the textbook only in Telugu. Okay, clay black soils are నల్ల రేగడి భూమి. ఓకే స్టూడెంట్స్, నౌ లెట్ us see. సో దిస్ సాయిల్ విల్ బి అవైలబుల్ 15 feet depth available. It's available up to 15 feet depth. 15 feet depth available in the Penamakuru village. And this soil is very sticky. Now features of the soil, let us see how it will be. It is very sticky. See, even now if you will buy in the market the artificial clay color, you will make into different shape. Because some sticky means like a gum, stickiness will be present in the soil, that artificial. Even in this clayey black soil also, it's naturally very sticky. It's naturally very sticky. You can make any toy with this. But you have to mix it with water and you can give any shape. Okay, students. So, this is very sticky with rain. So, now, when it rains, this soil becomes very sticky. And retain moisture for a long time. That means like alluvial black soil, even this soil also holds water for a long time. Retain moisture means nothing but wetness. Retain moisture for a long time. Okay students, and see, first clay black soils on Nallaregadi Bhumi. It will find in the Penamakuru village up to 15 feet depth. And this soil is sticky. Whenever it rains, it becomes very sticky. If we walk also, very sticky it will be. And it will hold water for a long time, retain moisture for a long time. Now, after rain, after few days, it dries, isn't it? When it dries, it tends to crack. It tends to crack. Means what I am saying, when it dries, automatically the soil cracks. In between the soil, the cracks will come. Cracks means, you know, some gaps. For our legs also in the winter season, we'll get cracks, isn't it? So like that, the cracks will come in the soil. When it dries. When the soil sticky, you know, when it rains. After that, it retains moisture for a long time. When it dries, it tends to crack. It tends to crack, means gaps they will get. So this tends to crack, what happens, you know, we get the cracks. So that is called self-plowing. It is called self-plowing. Why the word self-plowing is using? See, actually in agriculture fields, to sow the seeds, to put the seeds, they has to plow the land, they has to dig, isn't it? But here, when clay black soil is there, it is very sticky, it retains moisture for a long time. When it dries, some gaps they will get. So, no need of plowing. Automatically gaps are there, they can sow seeds directly. That's why it is called self-plowing. This cracks only called as the self-plowing. Understood? Once again I repeat and then I will end this class. And I'll ask you some questions also now. See, clay black soil. First type of soil, what I said? I said that alluvial black soils. After that, clay black soils, isn't it? So, alluvial black soil is also called as Ondru Bhumi. It is very fertile and it also holds water for a long time and nutrients are present in the alluvial black soil. Second, we discussed about the clay black soil or Nallaregadi Bhumi. So, we will find in Penamakuru village up to 15 feet depth this kind of soil available. And this soil will be very sticky when it rains. And this also will hold water for a long time. When it dries, it tends to crack. Cracks will come in the soil. So, cracks means gaps. So, automatically they can sow the seeds. So, it tends to crack. It's cracking, no need of plowing. That's why it is called as self-plowing. Now, I would like to ask few questions here. Recapitulation for you students. I think so you have listened my lesson. Understood, I am expecting. Now, I would like to ask you few questions. Where is Penamakuru village situated? Where it is situated? Even I'll post answers for this question. These answers you learn. No need of writing these questions, short questions in the notes. Only you have to learn. Notes question answers will be different. Now, when and where Prakasham barrage was built? Okay, students. Third question, from which of the village Bandar canal flows? Then fourth, name the soils found in Penamakur. Just I explained now only two kinds of soils. Okay. But one more kind of soil is also available in this village. Let us discuss tomorrow. Okay. Then you have to write about the alluvial soil. Next questions, write about alluvial soil. What I taught about the alluvial soil, whatever you remember, you once recapitulate it. Okay, students, what I said? I said it is fertile soil. Okay. And what I said, they are nutrients and it have water holding capacity. Then next, write about the clay black soil. These are the questions, students, recapitulation questions, students. Okay. So you have to learn. Again,